Hi guys, today I want to go to Trimble Siteworks and some calibrations. So I went to the Trimble website, link is going to be in below. You register and I downloaded the latest and greatest emulator for the Trimble Earthworks. When you open it up, it will obviously, as usual, bring you to the main screen. And let's go take a look at the settings and system info. And as you can see, this is version 1.44. Whole bunch of other stuff. Okay, anyway, the reason I wanted to bring that up because the calibration procedure has changed slightly. It's still the same. You can do the 1 point, you can do the predefined projection or inclined plane by, you know, three or more points. However, the way it works is slightly different. So let's do a project and let's change project and create a new project and call it test 1 point. I'm here, so I'll put it in metric, northeast, hit next. So you have this option of importing stuff into your project. If you do not import anything, gets you to the work order, right? So let's do calibration. We don't have any design, we'll hit accept, and it's gonna take us to setting up a rover. Let's do set up a connect device. I'm gonna do a rover and I'm gonna do 985 emulator, radio and receiver. Let's say channel 1 emulator, of course, quick release, 2 meters, accept. So the first thing it's gonna ask us, rover setup is complete. Do you wanna calibrate the project now? Once you hit yes, it's gonna ask you for the point, north and easting and elevation, and obviously if you want to use a GeoAid and the name. Once you hit measure, it gets you to this screen, right? How many epochs you want to make, how many seconds or minutes you want to take the observation. I'm just gonna leave the default, and once you hit yes, it's gonna get you going to screen where it's gonna take the shot. So this is what we would call a 1 point calibration before. Obviously it failed because it's an emulator, but whatever, right? So let's go and do the second. So I'm gonna go change project and then I'm gonna do new project. I'm gonna go test predefined. And once I get here, I can hit and select the coordinate system. So let's say Canada, 114, and I'll use this GeoAid and hit accept, hit finish. Again, we got the code cow, finished. So this would be your predefined. So if your project is in a predefined projection, you see it's asking us to adjust. So then I would go and find the monument, type in the coordinates and hit that, which would adjust the, you know, local shift or whatever. So that would be predefined. Now what we want to do is how do we do if we have a local coordinate system and we want to do incline plane. So I'm gonna do new, call it test local, and I'm gonna select control file, right? So you can do style, whatever, file name, CSV, tap to select file. So I'm just gonna go to one of my previous jobs, whatever, and just pull a coordinate file off that, okay, and hit finished. Again, next one is gonna be calibration, the work order, once you hit finished, What this does is it loaded up the points file in there. So now I can go to project and do project calibration. Here I'm gonna hit the plus sign and either zoom out. If I know that I'm on this point, then I can click on the point, it's gonna pick up the number. Or if I know which number I am on, I can do it by clicking these three lines and selecting the point map. Once I have it selected, I'm gonna go and do my 15 second observation. Once I'm done with this observation, then I can move my rover to the next point, next point, next point. Once I hit more than 3 points, obviously the emulator will crash, right? Once I have 3 points, it will give me my residuals, and that would, once I'm happy with my residuals, I'll be able to turn on and off the horizontal or vertical to kind of tighten it up. And once I have that and I'm happy with my calibration, I can close my calibration, write it, and basically do my survey in my local coordinates. So this was the biggest change. If you do not have control points in your file, it will automatically take you to the one point. So before starting local calibration for you, where you want to do your incline plane, you have to have points in there. Whether you import them or input them manually, it's up to you. However, just be careful that once you hit a project and you have no points in there, it's going to take you automatically to the one point. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.